that moment,
I thought, okay, now I'm going to die.
This man comes running against us and he repeats the same words. They're all dead, they're all dead, they're all dead.
They felt cold, they were ice cold. The clinically dead young teenagers.
Yeah, I remember now. Yeah. It was so freezing, it was so cold, and there was ice on the water. Yeah.
Sorry.
It was hard weather, it was very windy.
The boat flipped in the middle of the sea, then all people held out.
I landed under the boat, and when I came up from the water, the nightmare began. Everybody was screaming, and everything was like unreal. You could just see the panic. The teacher said that we had to swim in, because else we would die.
I couldn't swim. One of my friends came over to me and tried to help me, but after a short time, I was clinically dead because of the temperature of the water.
And it was really hard because you didn't have any strength in your legs. And I was keeping falling down. And in that moment, that was where I thought, okay, now I'm going to die. And then I saw the man. Thank God for that. And when I saw him, I were screaming so loud.
We had landed with our helicopter. This man came running against us and he repeats the same words. They're all dead, they're all dead, they're all dead.
They felt cold, they were ice cold. When you are as cold as they were, we know that we can resuscitate. They are dead, but not really dead. We still have a chance. At that point, we aimed at warming the blood 1 degree per 10 minutes. Kasper was 17.5 when he came. He recovered and had his normal heart rhythm back around 26 degrees. Main focus from then on was the brain. Will these patients recover?
My father took some pictures where I'm laying in the bed.
And you were in a coma when this picture was taken. And that's the respirator who kept you breathing because you couldn't breathe by yourself.
It's weird to see yourself laying there, pretty much dead.
I could see a hint of a smile, and then I knew he recognized me. And I was so happy. You can't describe the feeling. Everyone was so happy because everybody awoke that day. Every parent was in the waiting room, and we just got out there and screamed and jumped. And we were so filled with laughter and happiness because everybody was waking up. Mentally, sometimes I get some breakdowns. The worst part is maybe when I'm in school because I'm not that good to remember things.
We can't see any abnormalities in their scans, and that is amazing. This is the largest number of accidental hypothermic victims that has been resuscitated all at once, and with a 100% survival.
When you have nearly died, it's just, it is a little different. And it's hard to explain because you were so close to lose it, but now you know you have it.